A legacy from the Soviets, Mongolia's railways still serve as the landlocked country's lifeline, ferrying goods and passengers every day. Trains heading south are more frequent these days, and on this China-bound train, passengers reflect on shifting local sentiments about their southern neighbor.
We have to look forward. China is so much more developed than us. They are ahead of us by so many years. Russia is much more developed than us. Instead of trying to catch up with them, we keep talking about history, saying Chinese are like this. They did this and that to us. I don't want to talk like that.
Mongolians like Uzbol say they're frustrated with their country's inability to tap into their mineral resources. China is Mongolia's largest trade partner, and its One Belt, One Road program could also bring in investment for crucial projects spanning roads, potential oil pipelines, and new railway developments Mongolia desperately requires.
There have been very few upgrades to Mongolia's railways since it was completed in 1961 as part of the Trans-Siberian Railway, which connects Beijing and Moscow. Local passenger trains like this one travel to the borders daily and are essential for traders and travelers. But Mongolia's government is hoping trilateral trade talks with China and Russia can help expand its railway network to increase mineral exports and reach customers more quickly.
Projects that have perked Chinese interest include a long-proposed new railway track to reach coal deposits in northern Mongolia and into Russia's Tuva province.
This northern corridor opens up not just northern Mongolia, but also southeastern Russia. And then very much Mongolia is a transit corridor for all sorts of trade running past our coal deposit. So all of a sudden, it's not just to a coal deposit, this is about regional development.
This includes proposals to modernize and double Mongolia's single-track railway. If all goes to plan, the government believes it has much to gain as a strategic economic corridor between its two powerful neighbors.
It will help not only foster investments and infrastructure development, it could be very beneficial also to foster understanding and trust.
A statue of the historic Silk Road's most famous Western traveler stands in downtown Ulaanbaatar. It serves as a reminder of the glory days of the Mongol Empire when Marco Polo visited. The Mongolia of today wants a role in the new Silk Road that could help it become rich and important once more. Pearly Jacob, Al Jazeera, Ulaanbaatar, Mongolia.